Hi, it's Corinne for the Cut at Home Design Team, and today I have a fun project to share with you. I have a full start to finish on this video that I will play in a moment here, and I will have all the measurements on Cut at Home's blog. So if you need to refer to any of the measurements, then just please check out Cut at Home's blog. All the links will be in the description box along with all the products you use. But just to quickly show you, I used for my base some Craft Color Nina cardstock, and I use the gorgeous Craftsmith Tea Party collection. On the front here I have a Marianne Designs bow. I love this bow. I ran these through my Sizzix Big Shot. I have a pearl brad in the center, and I used a Marianne Designs die cut here, this large heart and this love definition. I added a craft circle in a 2-inch circle punch, and then this I used a 1¾-inch circle punch. I used some rosette trim that I had in my stash from Saw Crafters. And when you open it up, on the front here, I used some Spellbinders Nestability dies with the paper collection. And this little banner I had in my stash, I added some pearls to it just for decoration. And each page flips open, and every single one has a pull-out mat for more photos. So photos can be added on the pages themselves, which I would have a hard time doing because I love this paper so much, but this makes a great photo album for lots of photos. So I hope you stay tuned for the start to finish. Check out the description box for all the links, and thanks so much for stopping by. Okay, to get started, I pulled out some craft paper, and this is the Nina Midtone. It is 65 pound. You can use whatever you'd like, but you do want to use a little bit heavier weight for the front and back cover. I will be using this for the front back cover and my inside pages. So to get started, we're going to work on the album of the cover. We need two pieces of paper cut to 6x8. I already have my two pieces here, and one's going to be the front and one's going to be the back. We're going to score them a little bit differently. That's why we need to determine which one we'll use for the front and back. It doesn't matter which one you start with, but the scoring will be different. So for my back piece, you want to pull out your scoreboard, and on the 6-inch side, you want to score it at 1/2 inch. And 5½ inches. So we've scored it at 1/2 inch on either side. Okay, then you want to flip it to the 8-inch side and score it at 1/2 inch, 1½ inches, and 2 inches. All of this information will be on Cut at Home's blog as well. So again, we scored it at 1/2, 1½, and 2 inches. Okay, and that's for our back piece. For our front piece, again, putting it in on the 6-inch side, we want to score it at 1/2 inch on either side. So 1/2 inch and 5½. Go ahead and flip it to the 8-inch side. We want to score it at 1/2 inch, 6 inches, and 6½ inches. So again, starting with our back piece, you want to use a strong adhesive. I'm using Angel Craft Tape. It comes in several sizes, 1/8 inch, 1/4 inch, and 1/2 inch. So to start, I'm going to use the 1/4 inch. And you want to go ahead and adhere the three sides. This is where we have our two score marks, 1/2 inch and 1/2 inch. Go ahead and add your adhesive to those 1/2 inch. Okay, and again, here is the back side. Let me show it to you this way. Here's where we have all our score marks. I'm going to miter this corner here. So I'm just going to go up to that score line. I'm not going to go over it, and I'm going to miter it. So let me show you here what I'm talking about. I'm going to do that to both of these bottom ends. And now we want to glue them down. So pull off all your back tape backing. And fold along those 1/2 inch score lines. And go ahead and go over it with your bone folder. And you can also fold up on your score marks as well. Okay, so set that aside, and now we'll work on the front cover. We want to, again, add our tape on all three sides where there is a 1/2 inch score mark. Exact same thing where our two score marks meet at the bottom where there's a 1/2 inch, we want to miter those corners. And now go ahead and fold along your score lines. Give it a nice crease. Remove the tape backing. And adhere those down. I'm going to go ahead and fold along my score lines at the top here. Okay, now this is going to be our front cover and our back cover. So let me show you how this works. This is going to attach to this and sit inside of our matchbook piece right here. Okay, that gives us a 1/2 inch gusset at the top and at the bottom, and this will adhere down. So what you want to do is go ahead and adhere this up to your score line, but not over this score line. That way it gives the album a chance to flip up and down. So for that, I think I'm going to use wet adhesive. And what I'm going to do is add adhesive to this entire bottom flap, making sure to do a good job, get the sides. And then I'm going to glue the top flap of this so I can make sure it's glued all the way to the top. And adhere that down. Wet glue gives you a chance to kind of adjust it and move it around, make sure you're really happy with it because you want it to line up very nicely. That way you don't see any of the seams once we add our decorative paper. So again, I'm just really pressing that down, making sure it's adhered very well. Okay, now this gives us our front cover. It will be like this and it will sit inside of that. So let me set this aside and we'll get started on the inside pages. For our paper, we are going to cut a piece at 5.5. These are for our inside pages. 5.5 So we have two pieces out of an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper that are both 5.5. One of them we need to cut it at 6. So this is 6 by 5.5. And then we need to cut another one at 5.5. Excuse me, at 5. So again, we have two pieces, 5.5 by 5 and 6 by 5.5. This is the 6 by 5.5. Go ahead and put it in at the 6-inch mark and score it at 1/2 inch on either side. So score it at 1/2 inch and 5.5 inches. Okay, so again on the 6-inch, we scored it in at 1/2 and 5/2. Then go ahead and rotate it 90 degrees. This is on the 5.5 inch side, and choose one of the sides to score it in at 1 inch. So score it in at 1 inch. Okay, set that aside. Now we have the 5.5 by 5 piece. Go ahead and place it in at 5.5 inches and score it up 1 inch. That's the only score marks that we're going to be putting on this piece. So using the 6 by 5.5 that we have, we want to take out these two sections, okay, where the little tabs are. We want to cut that tab out. So I'm going to miter it just a tiny bit, and I'll show you here what we're doing in a second. This is just going to give us a nice fold. So here are the two pieces that we're cutting out. Throw those away. Go ahead and score on your fold lines. I want to give my tabs a good crease because we're going to be adhering this to our other page. So now we want to take our 5.5 by 5 piece and glue it directly onto this. I'm also going to miter these corners so you don't see them when they're folded. I'm just taking just the tiniest bit off. Just a tiny bit off. It's not something you have to do, but it does help to hide that seam a little. So I just took a tiny bit off. So again, we want to add our adhesive to our flaps. Now we want the two sides that have the score marks to meet at the bottom. We want to line up those score marks. So I have a score mark on this side, and at this side we're going to adhere them this way. So I'm going to start up here at the top to make sure it's nice and centered. And adhere that down. So now we have our pocket with our flaps at the bottom. And these will sit inside of our matchbook box. Or album, I should say. So go ahead and use some wet adhesive and glue these tabs down together. I'm going to decide now how many I'm going to make. I'm going to start out with 4, and I'll be right back to tell you if I'm happy with 4 of them. So I'll be right back. Okay, so I made all my pockets, and I did end up going with 6 pockets, and I ended up gluing all the bottoms down together. Like I showed you, I used wet glue for that. And what we are going to do is all the ones with these the 1-inch score marks or the tabs on the bottom, we're going to adhere them together. So I'm going to use probably either wet glue or hot glue, and where the tabs are at the bottom, I'm going to adhere them together. Before I do that though, I think it's easier to adhere my design paper down on the front and back cover. And for that, you're gonna need them to be cut at 4 7/8 inch wide by 4 3/8 inch tall. Again, all the information, all the measurements will be on Cut at Home's blog. The paper pad I'm using is Tea Party by Craftsmith, and I'm going to adhere all my adhesives with my Angel Craft Tape, and I'll be right back. So I've adhered all my papers on, and now I'm going to adhere the bottoms together. I thought I would do one on camera just to show you. What I'm going to do is line them up at the top, make sure they're even at the top. I'm going to hold them in place as best as I can, flip this up, and use some hot glue. And press it down. I'm going to do the same with the next. I want to make sure the top and sides are as even as possible. I will flip it up and use some hot glue. So I'm going to continue with that process until they're all glued together. So they're all adhered together, and this is how they will sit in the book. If you want to make an inside mat piece for inside your pocket, which we did leave enough on top so you can leave a little mat to stick out, then you want to cut this to 4 7/8 by 4 7/8. You can also use a decorative punch at the top, which is what I will most likely do. So I'm going to get all of those prepared. Okay, so to cover the inside, you're going to need two pieces, and you're going to need these same sizes on the outside. I haven't cut the outside pieces yet, but just to give you the measurements, we're going to need a 4 7/8 by 5 3/8. A piece for the middle, you're going to need 4 7/8 by 3/8. And for the bottom, you're going to need a 4 7/8 by 5 7/8. So again, you're going to need for the inside and the outside of your book. I'm going to adhere these down, and I'll be right back. So I have adhered all my papers on, and again, the measurements that I gave you for the inside is going to be the exact same for the outside. However, for this piece, you need a 4 7/8 by 7/8 inch piece. And then just try to match it up as best you can with the rest of them, how much border you left. So here is my front, my inside. We don't need to worry about this because you won't see that, and then it will flip in like this. So now the next thing we want to do is take our pieces and adhere them down. So what I'm going to do is kind of set it down into place. Make sure the sides are lined up as best you can, and once you're happy with it, then go ahead and glue it down. So I'm just going to kind of take a look, make sure it's where I want. Take your time with this. Sometimes this takes me a couple minutes, but and then what I like to do is just kind of hold it in place and bring the glue or the flap up to this. Okay, so I'm really happy with that. Now you do not want to adhere it all the way down because you need a little space for the top to slide into this. Okay, so I'm going to add glue. I'm using hot glue, and I'm not going to adhere it all the way to the very top. And you also don't want your flap to go over your score lines on your pages because you need your pages to turn out to be able to flip up. So just kind of hold that in place for a few minutes. Make sure it is adhered well. Okay, and then it should slide right in the top here, which makes it our matchbook. So here is our little book. When you open it up, you have all your pages to flip through. And then I did end up putting a decorative edge on all of my papers. So these stick out just enough. Okay, so now I will put it in Fast Play and decorate it. I, again, will list all the products on Cut at Home's blog. If you have any questions, please leave me a comment. I did want to mention that we did glue all our pockets to the front of this flap. We also need to add glue to the back of this 1-inch portion and glue it to the back of our book. So I'm going to add some hot glue and just place this down. So again, this is the front of the book, and we adhered the front flap that our cover sits in. We also need to glue the back.